In this video, I will show you how to get started with Piwigo and set up your photo library in less than 15 minutes. First, I will assume that you have already created your trial account on piwigo.com. So I will log in for the first time to my new gallery just here. First, when you log in the first time, Piwigo will ask you if you are an enterprise or an individual. It's just that the pricing is not the same whether you are an enterprise, administration, association, or just a person like you and me. So I will advise you not to lie about it, just to pay less, because we will see it very quickly. But for now, I will answer later. When I land on my new Piwigo account for the first time, Piwigo will tell me that my photo gallery is empty. So the first thing I want to do is to add photos. We say photos because Piwigo is a photo library software, but it's more than that. And it could be videos, it could be PDF, it could be any kind of files if you have an enterprise account. But for today, I will have some photos. So I want to click here. And I land on my administration. It's like a kind of back office of Piwigo. It's where I can set up my gallery, add photos, organize them in albums, etc., etc. So first, I need to create an album. An album is like a folder. So in Piwigo, you cannot add files if you have not created first an album. So I create my first album here. I click on create, and I can add some photos in this album. I can click on add photos here, or I can just drag and drop files from my computer just right here. I will do that. So I'll take some files. I put them here. I can see the list here, and I just have to click on start upload, and my photos are very quickly uploaded. I could click on manage this set of 12 photos if I want to edit them in batch, like edit a description, add some tags, add anything else. I could add another set of photos, but for now, I just want to see how it looks like on my gallery. It's like the front office of my photo library, the website, where people can just see my photo library. So I have clicked on visit here, and I land on my gallery. You know, Piwigo has just created a website. Anyone who has this address can see my gallery. And by default, it looks like that. I can see the photos in my first album. We will be able to customize the design of this gallery. But for now, I just want to make sure that anyone who is not logged in on my gallery cannot see my photos, because they are just for me and my colleagues, if I am a company. So I will go back on the administration. I click on admin here, and I will go on album. Manage. I can see my first album here, and I click on edit. As you can see, there are lots of things that I could edit, like the name, description. I can edit the thumbnail that will represent my album on my gallery. But I will just click on permissions here. On this permission page, I can see that this album is for now public. It means that any visitor, any person who knows the address of my gallery can see this album and the photos in this album. Now I want to set this album private. I want that only people with an account on my Piwigo gallery can log in and see this album and the photos in it. So I will now set it private. I click on private, and I will grant the right to see this album to all the users in my gallery who can see it. For now, there is just me on this gallery, so I will allow me the right to see this album. I will click on Save Settings, and now my album is private. Now, I want to modify the look and feel of my gallery. I want to customize the design because finally the default theme is not okay for me. So I will now go to Configuration and Themes. And here you have a list of themes. Themes are templates, like models, that will apply to your Piwigo gallery. And Piwigo is installed by default with a lot of themes created within the years. And by default, the theme that has been activated on your gallery when you created it the first time is Modus. It's the most popular theme for now. It has the advantages of being compatible with lots of plugins for Piwigo, and it's okay whatever the device you are using. The theme is compatible with mobile phones, tablets, and all kind of screens. So first, I want to see what I'm able to do to customize my gallery with the Modus theme. So I'll click here on Configuration, and I can see that we have some skins, what we call skins. It's like color schemes. And I can choose one that is that I prefer over the default theme in black and white. So I can click on Preview if I want to see more what it will look like. And let's say that I like the swimming pool skin for Modus. I can choose it. You can see you have several other options. Like you can add a page banner on your homepage for your gallery with Modus. I'll just click here on Save Settings. And if I click on Visit and go back on my gallery, I can see that colors have changed. Now, let's explore the other themes available. Now, I'll go back to Themes. And I want to see what it will look like with another theme like Bootstrap Darkroom, another very popular theme for Piwigo. So I click here on Activate, and this theme is now available on my gallery. But if I want that Bootstrap Darkroom is the default theme for every user who will go to my gallery, I have to set it as default. So I click on Set as Default, and if I go back to my gallery and refresh, I see that the look and feel has completely changed. Now, the theme used on my Piwigo gallery is Bootstrap Darkroom. If I go back on the configuration of my theme here, I just have to click on Configuration under Bootstrap Darkroom. I can see that there are lots and lots of color schemes available for this theme. Let's say I wanted blue. I can choose material blue. I can choose light green. I can choose red. And I can test lots of options. Some options change only the color, but some can change also the font style. Well, you have lots of options to customize your Piwigo with a Bootstrap Darkroom. You have other options to customize it, like add a site logo, a banner, change the category page display, or you can even, if you know how to do it, add some custom CSS code and really customize your Piwigo gallery just like you want. Let's say that I like the light green color scheme. I just click on Save Settings. I go back to my gallery, refresh, and that's it. Now it's red. If you want more customization on your gallery and you don't have the time or the skills to do it, you have to know that if you have an enterprise account on piwigo.com, our team will customize your gallery according to your brand identity and your needs. So just have a look on piwigo.com website. You can see some examples of customizations that we have done for customers. You really can do lots of things with Piwigo. Let's show you a last things about themes. I go back to configuration theme, and here you can see that there is one theme activated by default on your gallery. It's called Smart Pocket. What is it? It is a theme that is optimized for mobile devices. So if you activate it, like it is by default, your gallery will have another look and feel when you visit it from a mobile phone. You can see what it looks like. You don't have to keep it if you don't want to. If you use Modus or Bootstrap Darkroom for your gallery, these themes are already optimized for mobile devices, so you can just here click on the three dots and deactivate if you don't want to use Smart Pocket theme when your gallery is visited from a mobile device. To end this quick tour of Piwigo, I will show you how to invite users to your Piwigo account, because Piwigo is more fun when you share it with your friends or colleagues. So I'll click here on Users, Manage, and I will just add a user to my Piwigo account. I'll click here to add a user, and let's say I want to invite a colleague, Mark, and I want him to be able to upload pictures and organize my photo library just like me. So I will invite Mark. I will let Piwigo generate a password instead of choosing it for him, because it's more secure. So I click on Generate Random Password. I'll add Mark's email and just check here, and Mark will receive an email with all the information to access to Piwigo and logging on his own account. I click to add users, and my user is created. By default, Mark is just a random user, a normal user. What does it mean? That means it's not an administrator. He will be able to log in on my gallery to see albums and photos that are private, but he will not be able to connect to the administration and to upload new pictures and to add albums and manage the Piwigo. I want him to be an administrator, so I click here on the little pencil and I will give him the administrator status. So I click on update, and that's it. Mark and I will be able to continue to create our photo library on Piwigo. And that's it for today. I hope this video has been a great help for you, to help you get started with your new Piwigo account. If you need some help, just feel free to contact us. We will always be supportive to our new user. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.